she came home that day, even I could tell something bad had happened to her. I knocked on her door. There was no reply. I knocked again. And Sully came into the room. I peered at her and said, "I'll stay with you. What happened today? Please talk to me." She still didn't say anything. Finally, she looked up and said, "It was just a rough day, okay? Maddie and I got into a fight." I began to gently rub her back. I tried to soothe her. "Sadie, I'm really sorry. You're right. Junior year does suck, and there's no better way to put it. You know Maddie, she's always been a bit more emotional and likes to exaggerate a couple of things. But maybe it's a sign that you guys are just going your separate ways. That happens sometimes in high school. Friends grow apart for different reasons, and that's okay. You know, you still have your whole life ahead of you, and there's bound to be plenty of people who will go in and out of it. You just have to choose to keep the ones in it that are going to be positive and support you. If Maddie's not going to do that anymore, then maybe it's time to let her go. You shouldn't feel bad about that. Okay?" Sadie sighed. "All right," she said. "Thank you. I know you mean that. And the advice helps. Sometimes things are just easier said than done." I looked at her. "Of course, Sadie," I said. "I will always be here for you, too. If you need anything, let me know. Don't forget, I have a pretty mean right hook, too, if Maddie starts to act up again." I winked at her and walked out of the room.